This induction motor on my new strip sander has a separate main winding and starter winding, and if I just activate the main winding, it just hums without starting. So to start this motor, I also have to engage the starter winding briefly. And once the motor is started, the starter winding isn't necessary. It actually has two starter windings. This one starts it in the reverse direction. Now, normally the starter winding is engaged by a mechanical switch that's actually coupled to some centrifugal weights. On this motor, it's quite visible. So if I turn this motor on, you can see that switch just clicked over, and if I let it run down, that re-engages the switch for the next startup. But on this motor, the starter switch function was actually done by the electronics on the main controller board, which I don't have. So I have to come up with some kind of substitute. Ideally, I would have some kind of mechanical switch where if I push the on button, it closes both of those switches to engage the main winding and the starter winding here. And as soon as I let go of the on button, it disengages this switch. So basically, as long as I push the on button, the starter winding is engaged. And then to turn it off, I would then open the switch. But I don't have such a switch. So my first thought was to just use a couple of really cheap, simple, mechanical household light switches like this and have some kind of lever in front of a pair of them so that to throw the lever to on, it'll engage both of them. And as soon as I let go of the lever, a spring will disengage the start switch. And then when I throw the lever to stop, it'll turn off the main switch as well. But that would make for a bit of a complicated arrangement, plus a spring to turn the other switch back, so it's a temporary switch. Now you may have noticed when I disengaged the starter coil, that made quite a spark, and if I put a capacitor in parallel to that, that will cut down on the spark quite a bit, which will make the switch last a lot longer. So I've got a 0.47 microfarad 400 volt AC capacitor in parallel with the contact that I need to close here, so let's try that out. So that was almost no spark. Let's try it without the capacitor again. So then I rummaged through my junk and I have this AC relay, and that has a coil that runs on, takes about 90 volts to activate this coil. And I came up with this fancy circuit, and basically that eliminates a lot of the mechanical aspects of it. So in this circuit, I start by turning on the starter winding. And once the starter winding is engaged, that from here to here is more than 100 volts, engages this coil here of the relay, which turns on the main winding. And then when I let go of the start button, that opens up again, and the relay keeps the main winding engaged until I disconnect power with another switch here, at which point, without any power to the motor, there's no longer any voltage induced on the starter windings, and the starter relay disconnects. And that means I just need two temporary switches, this one temporarily on and this one temporarily off. Except I couldn't find any reasonably priced temporary switches online, so I'm going to use two springs on a piece of wood like this in front of the switches, like this, and that makes both of these switches temporary. And one is temporary on and the other one is temporary off just by flipping it upside down so that the spring turns one on and the other one off. And this box should be big enough to mount the relay circuit right here. Okay, I've got my circuit very neatly prototyped. This is the start switch and this is the stop switch. And here's the relay, here's the motor. Just gotta plug it in. Actually, it is already plugged in. So now temporarily engaging the start switch will start it up. And temporarily engaging the stop switch stops it. And start it again. Now I do have to hold that switch long enough for it to get up to speed. And stop. I soldered the wire straight to the relay because I don't have a socket for it, and if this relay breaks, I don't have a replacement anyways. Although, if the contacts go, it's got several contacts, so I can switch that. And this is the on switch with a cap across it. This is the normally on switch for interrupting power for turning it off. It's already plugged in, so let's try that out. Okay, I didn't turn it on long enough. Let's try again. And now temporarily turn this off. Works. Now I just got to put it in this box. All right, I got my circuits jammed into this box, ready to close it up. I changed my mind about having the off switch being just a temporary interrupter, because if I just have it go off on this switch and leave it off, it doesn't matter what the relay does, it's just plain off. And also, I wired a dust collector in also to go directly off of this switch. So now if I plug this in and I turn this on, that just turns on the dust collector, this thing right there, and then if I touch this, that starts the sander. And to turn it off like this. And probably what I'll do to turn it on, I'll probably just touch it with two fingers like this. And the relay is still useful because without it, if I put this switch in the on position, without hitting the starter, that would burn out the motor. But the relay keeps the motor from being powered on until the starter's hit. And in fact, one cool feature of this is if the motor stops running for whatever reason, that actually automatically kills the switch too, because if the motor stalls, there's no more induced voltage on the starter coil, and that means the relay just clicks off. And now I've got the switch mounted on the machine. I just finished editing this video and I just thought I'd add a note at the end because it seems the world has really changed since I started filming that video not that long ago. We're all okay, there's a few cases in town, everything is shut down, so I think the odds of getting the virus are pretty small. But with the kids home all day, or at least sometimes the grandparents take them out, it's hard to find long enough stretches of time to really start anything. So don't expect any machine builds in the next few months for sure. And I was expecting my productivity to kind of grind to a halt soon once the baby's born, but that's still a month and a half away. So anyways, yeah, no machine builds for a while. I will make shorter videos of simpler stuff probably, but yeah, that's how things are here. Hope you're okay too.